Hello, my name is Indrajit. I live at the foothill of the Mount Kinga. In the 17th century, Mughals were effectively wiped out from whole of India. In fact, Mughals were never ruling whole of India. So, Shivaji's army wiped them out, and from Shiv Sahi, which was a pure Hindu Sahi, and during this time period, big temples was built, religious establishment was enriched, the stone temples were rejuvenated, Hindus relaxed a bit, the Dharma was prevalent, and Maratha flag was saffron. So the invading Muslims were effectively wiped out. Hindu Sahi was established most of the India. Even it extended to the Kabul, Afghanistan, today's Pakistan. So, but it remained Islamic rule in the Bengal. From this gap, British's East India Company established the Mir Qasim, Mir Jafar episode, and they established power in the Bengal, then Oud, and from that they had the Battle of Panipat. Marathas lost a lot of things, but still they hold there up to 60-70 years. They tried to resist, and their final resistance was 1857, which we say Sepoy Vidraha. Actually, it was a saffron. Marathas did it. After that, there was a constant struggle. Hindus always fought against the invaders. Who were these? Whether it was a Seleucus Nicator, Greeks, Huns, Iranians, whoever, they fought and they regained their independence. However fragmented it was, but they loved it, their independence, and they regained it time to time. The Hindu resistance was inborn into every Hindu. When Britishers established their rule, first they established at the Calcutta, and then they changed to the Delhi. Then there was a constant resistance. Now this resistance was somewhat, we can say, non-violent. That is, it was a big protest, constant protest. So British girls tried to ease them out. They introduced the political system. The parliament was constructed. A constitutional system was introduced. Monarchy had every power within them, but they were guided by the Niti Shastra and Manu Smriti, Yagvalkya Smriti, and other smritis. But when the Britishers came, they established a system that this is the executive, this is the justice system, and this is the rule making system. So police system was established, revenue system was established, judiciary was established, parliamentary system was established. and they created political parties, the famous Evo Hum. There were in all these things the mainstay of the British system was the executive. They created a native class, a class which understood their language, a class which understood their thought process, a class which was dedicated to them, a class which was created for them, and they gave their power to these executives. These executives were English speaking, they were the police, magisterial services, revenue services, judicial services. So these people wielded the true power, and their power come through the crown. So in their realm, in their jurisdiction, they were the boss. When British left, they had a limited democracy under the 1935 India Act. People were elected, selected, and they sat in the Vidhan Sabha, Dhara Sabha, Parliament, all way. So, but this political class was sympathetic toward the Raj. We say that independence was given. Was it given to the people that you people come, we give you independence, or bunch of the people gone to the crown and say, give us independence? No, bunch of the Rajas go to the crown and say, give us the independence. No, what they did not just left and say, you decide yourself. Or Indian National Army did not took over the Delhi and said, this is our independence, you Britishers go, we will do what we will like. No, it was not like that way. Independence was given to the Viceroy, to the Governor General, who is an executive head, who is an executive. So fact is that the power was transferred to the Governor General, and Governor General consolidated all the powers of the crown at that point of time. So it was mandated to the Governor General that you make an arrangement, and Governor General had an opportunity to make a difference or to continue the system which was before the 1947, and he chose, they chose, we chose, whoever, it comes out that we created a constitution assembly, we the constitution assembly itself ratified the constitution, and we the people were given power, we were given the citizenship, so that we can elect. This is the structure, this is the executive, this is the legislative, this is the judiciary, this is the rule, and we continue that rule. Our sovereign is not a British monarch, so but this, our sovereign is the constitution. So a new office was created, that was the political offices, and president, vice president, parliament, elections, voters, citizenships, later on decided. So in effective, even today, the true power rests with the executives. So it is important that if you want to be heard, you want a good system, then you should introduce good people, effective people, efficient people, broad-minded people to this executive system. So it is important for us to go into the executive and maintain the democracy the way it is. This democracy, whatever we say about it, but it is one of the best one we can get. It is one of the best one which is running, and it gives the aspiration to the people. It gives fulfillment. It gives joy. So it is important that we maintain, we help to maintain this constitution as it is. And for that, even if we don't go to the politics field, we should opt for the executive services, that is the government services, be it a nagarpalika, be it a gram panchayat, be it a district level, state level or center level services. We should opt for it. If we are capable, we should opt for it. It will benefit us, it will benefit our family, it will benefit the cause of the constitution. So executive has a power, and we can achieve that power by being part of it. Thank you. This was the 8th video in the political duck series, and time to time I will make more videos. I don't go by the numerical accuracies, but I try to make out the theories behind what is happening. So try to understand that theory and don't indulge into the numerical facts or truth. This is the theoretical part. Okay, this is the principle, and how to implement it, it's a different thing. And if time permits, I will also do something on earth. Thank you. Har Har Mahadev.